can start protecting your credit card information by investigating the website you're shopping on. Make sure the online retailer lists a real phone number and a physical address. Read the site's privacy policy and search for reviews and ratings of the retailer. You can read more about safe shopping online at STCU's financial education blog. Go to stcumoney.org.
Welcome to Let's Talk Spokane, where host Ryan McNeese seeks out and discusses the latest on a variety of hot local topics. Now, here's your host, Ryan McNeese.
Welcome to Let's Talk Spokane. I'm Ryan McNeese, and we're here in the studio with Tia Moua, Miss Outstanding Teen of Spokane, Miss Outstanding Teen of Washington, and you just got back also from Nationals.
I did.
Also with Monica Hawkinson, not only a Miss Spokane organization board member, but also a professional photographer. Mm-hmm. Thank you both for being here.
Thanks for having us, Ryan.
Thank you.
With this busy schedule, you literally just got back in town from Florida, I believe.
I did, yes.
Take us back to the beginning. How do you even prepare or get interested in this organization or these events?
Well, I started as a little princess in the Miss Spokane organization.
Okay.
So I saw a booth one day and saw these beautiful tiaras and thought, oh, Mom, I want to be a princess. And eventually I became a teen. So I competed for Miss Spokane's Outstanding Teen when I was 13 years old.
Okay.
And then again when I was 15 years old. And I won Miss Washington's Outstanding Teen this year over Memorial Day weekend.
Okay.
And got the exciting opportunity to go compete for Miss America's Outstanding Teen this past week.
Well, and that's fantastic. Where is the actual contest in Florida?
It's in Orlando, Florida.
It's in Orlando.
So
well,
at the Rosen
place.
Center. Yes.
And Monica, when Tia's indicating that she saw originally, got inspired by seeing the booth, obviously mm-hmm. that says something about the organization's outreach here locally.
Right.
That
right.
you're capturing the imagination of mm-hmm. These young contestants. Is that the goal, to really kind of have that outreach that brings in a number of contestants?
It is. We try to reach out to girls who are as young as 5.
Oh, okay.
And they can compete. Well, the princesses aren't. That's not a competition.
Right.
It's more of a mentor program. But once they turn 13, then they can compete in the teen division, and then we also have our Miss, which is 17 to 24.
Okay, so the different segments mm-hmm. of the organization, and I think obviously important to note the scholarship piece. Tell us a little
yes.
bit about that, because obviously from a community standpoint, mm-hmm. That aspect and the scholarship is very critical.
Miss America organization is actually the largest provider for scholarships for women.
Okay.
Millions of dollars every year are given out, and Tia will absolutely tell you how much scholarship she has received.
Well, tell us a little bit about that, because I think that mm-hmm. To me, and I think to our listeners, I think that's what's so important is mm-hmm. what you're doing, not only here locally in the community, but then you're taking your talents abroad and representing mm-hmm. Spokane and representing Washington. But tell us more about that scholarship feature.
Yes, definitely. So I was honored to receive $44,000 to St. Norbert's College, and
wow.
after competing at Miss America's Outstanding Teen, they actually awarded every contestant with a four-year full ride to the University of Alabama. So it's so exciting
wow.
to be able to get so many scholarships to help with our education
yeah.
and to just further ourselves. And
well, and I don't think, I appreciate you elaborating on that, because I don't think most folks understand that there's that much financial or resource backing
yes.
to these competitions. And the talent that you're bringing to the obviously, to this organization. Let's talk a little bit about that. How, when you were originally preparing for Miss Outstanding Teen of Spokane,
yes.
and then maybe you can tell us where the crossover to Washington is as well, how do you prepare for that? What are the different elements of winning that competition?
Well, we have several phases of competition. We have the interview, which is an 8-minute interview with a panel of judges, just like this.
Yeah,
but
you're professional,
though. I would be
standing
up. Oh, thank
yeah.
you. It's a lot of practicing, though, mock
right.
interviews. And then we have, for the teens, we have a fitness routine that we have to perform in front of judges.
Okay.
Then we have an evening gown and onstage question where you get to look like a princess in your evening
right.
gown and answer a question on stage in front of your whole audience. And the
okay.
last phase of competition is the talent competition. And I do a dance since I'm a dancer. So
okay.
I just did a jazz dance called Remedy.
Well, and so with the jazz dance, is that a mm-hmm. bit part and parcel to the fitness exercise or totally different? Is that a totally different, do you bring the dance element into the fitness piece that you're doing, or is that just a different talent?
It's pretty different. Yes, okay. Talent can be anything from dancing to singing to piano or even drumming.
Okay.
I saw that on the Miss America's Outstanding Teen Stage. It was amazing. I just love seeing the talent that each girl brings.
It's interesting to see the diversity of what folks bring to the table. With the interview piece or the questions when mm-hmm. you're on stage, how do you prepare for that? Is there a certain parameter, if you will, for the types of questions you're going to get, or is it just you're standing up there and who knows what's fired at you?
It's sort of randomized because every question, that's why you have to prepare on a wide variety of different questions, because mm-hmm. there's a different possibility. It could be a political question, or it could be a question about what issues faces our youth today. Mm-hmm. So it can be a really big range of questions, and that's why in mock interviews, which Monica and my mm-hmm. other directors just helped me with so much, is that we have to prepare on a lot of different questions.
So doing those mock interviews and mock questions, do you mm-hmm. just find yourself firing many different variety
we
of
do.
Questions?
We do try to make sure that the girls feel well-rounded mm-hmm. in their knowledge, and Tia is amazing. Whenever she does an interview, it's more like a conversation, mm-hmm. and that's what it needs to be like, because if you can make the judges or anyone you're with feel comfortable, that's your goal.
Right.
But we also want to have a representative who is very well-spoken and has an opinion and can back it up.
Yeah.
So regardless of what your opinion is, when she's in an actual competitive interview, she has to be able to pull out all of this information about her platform and
right.
facts, and has she done her research, and can she articulate something that's really amazing?
Right.
And she can. So,
well, thank you.
And obviously, it's evident that mm-hmm. that's what you both do. And let's face it, you as a board member, you as Miss Outstanding Teen for Spokane and Washington, and then going to the Nationals, you are the symbol of, when people see on your sash, Washington, mm-hmm. you're representing
yes.
a large group of people. So I think,
right.
Monica, as you're saying, the critical nature of how are you representing our area, whether it be Spokane, Washington, or otherwise.
Yes.
So
definitely.
Clearly those skills are important, and it's impressive because I think you'd indicate you're going into your junior year at Rogers High School.
Yes, I will be a junior in high school this year, and freshman in college.
I want to talk about that. Mm-hmm. You'd indicated that you're doing the Running Start program, right?
Yes.
How do you juggle all of this? I mean, an average teen, if you will, might be going into their sophomore or junior year in high school, and that's what's on the list. And you're doing, starting the freshman year mm-hmm. in college, junior year at Rogers, doing Miss Spokane, Miss Washington, Outstanding Teen, and going to Nationals. How do you juggle all of that?
Well, it's definitely an exciting journey,
yeah.
and I'm always just thankful every day for all the opportunities that I get. But organization is key. It's something that has definitely stuck with me, and I had to
right.
build that throughout the years, because I definitely have to have a lot of communication with my parents or my board of directors and people who help support me to get me where I need to be, or help to plan my different events that I go make appearances at. So I definitely communicate with the people that I need to and just stay organized. I keep my calendar and plan out my week and make
right.
sure that my dance schedule is all good and my events. I'm communicating that with my parents and everybody.
And you bring up a good point in terms of interacting or collaborating with the board members in terms of the different events you're supposed to be at. How
yes.
does that work, Monica, in terms of is there a particular board member that works with a particular even contestant before the competition?
No, we all help all of the girls.
Okay.
We want these girls to show their best selves. And so we, of course, can't show any impartiality
sure.
towards any of the contestants, but we want them all to do well.
Mm-hmm.
So we help them as much as we can. Now, since Tia did win Miss Washington's Outstanding Teen,
right.
our job technically is over with her.
Okay.
Because now she does have state directors, and they are wonderful.
You gotta let her go.
They are.
You're going to have
we
to
We do, but it's been hard.
The cleaving process.
However, Lana Graves is the director for our Miss Washington Outstanding Teen, and she has been so generous in in letting us help her for preparation with nationals and also to book a few appearances as long as we run it through the state, absolutely, because they have a big schedule and a big calendar as well. So we have to go through Lana first, and then maybe we might be lucky to get Tia. So.
Well, we talked a little bit off camera with Tia that you'd indicated. I was wondering, how do you juggle the Washington obligations with the teen obligations? Mm-hmm. And you'd said that technically you step down, if you will, from that seat to
from
do Washington.
Spokane, yes.
Not that you're not highly involved in Spokane anyway. But.
I love to. I mean, Spokane, I was born and raised in Spokane, Washington, and I just love the homey feel and the beautiful scenery here. It just Washington and Spokane is my home.
We're a pretty unique, what do they call us, a little big city, you know, roughly 500,000 or thereabouts. I think we're really fortunate. I agree with you, Tia, that you have everything you could ask for, and you don't have some of the negatives, I think, of the bigger cities.
Tia is actually the first Miss Washington's Outstanding Teen from this area.
Oh, really?
So she's the first Eastern Washington.
Okay.
So it's been a learning experience, I think, for the state directors as to be able, because we want this program to be broadcasted and really represented. So we don't want to leave out Spokane because that's where she's from.
Right.
And so we are working together to make sure that she has appearances on both sides of the state.
Well, see, and again, representing both sides of the state. What do you believe the difference between the preparation of each of these individual events, where you had the Spokane event, the Washington event, and then obviously recently coming back from Orlando, Florida? What was the difference in the preparation, or maybe even the difference in the actual event itself?
I think each time that I would compete for the next level, it would just be a different level of intensity. Mm-hmm. I think that each time I would just have to push myself to be even more well-rounded, to go to even more appearances and just understand myself a little bit more and work with my platform, volunteerism, giving your time and talents more.
Right.
Because I love my platform so much. It's all about giving back to the community and encouraging others to get involved with volunteering, because I believe that it's so important for people to get out in their community and get active. So
I
definitely just continue working with my platform and meeting new people during appearances. So
let's actually take a short little break. And what I do want to come back to is talking more about your platform.
Awesome,
because
it
appears to me that from the Miss Spokane organization, that platform piece really is the critical backbone of what you're doing with this organization.
It is,
let's
yes,
come right
yes.
back from a short break and talk a little more.
Awesome.
Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
In touch, online all the time. SpokaneTalksOnline.com.
What is that you're holding? The spokesman review? Is it really even a factor in driving customer traffic anymore?
Yeah, sure is. Here, close your eyes and imagine a few people with $5 bills in their hands standing outside the door of your business.
Okay. I see them. I like it. People with money. What's your point? $5 isn't that much.
I know, but what if there were 300,000 people in front of your door with $5 bills in their hands?
Well, now you got my attention. That's $1.5 million. 300,000 people. Where'd they come from?
Yeah, that's how many different people read the Spokesman Review every week in print, online, or on their mobile.
Wow, that's impressive.
All you got to do is invite them in. Run some ads.
The Spokesman Review has 300,000 readers a week? That's amazing. I had no idea.
Most people don't. That's why we're running this ad. In print and online, the Spokesman Review delivers customers for your business.
Snoring can disrupt marriages and cause serious health problems. Call Sleep Better Northwest first, the experts in dental sleep medicine. Their medically approved, custom-fit oral appliances will have both you and your partner sleeping better and being more productive throughout your day. Don't wait. Snoring and sleep apnea can signal potential strokes or heart attacks. For more information, visit needbettersleepnow.com and download our health guide today. Sleep Better Northwest, the experts in dental sleep medicine.
What? You haven't been to the library lately? Stop in today and see that the library is more than books. Spokane County Library District facilities feature on-site technology, including Wi-Fi, computers, and printers, as well as free use of meeting rooms. The library district offers events and programs for all ages, from story times to career development and employer classes to social security workshops. Our staff is well-trained and happy to help. Find out more about your library at scld.org.
Welcome back to Let's Talk Spokane. I'm Ryan McNeese, and we're here with Tia, Miss Hello. Outstanding Teen of Spokane and of Washington, and just got back from Nationals, and we're talking with Monica Hawkinson on the organization board as well. Right before we left for break, we got into what I think we all believe is really the critical backbone of the organization, Miss Spokane, the organization, is the platform that you work on and put forth and travel around speaking about. Tell us more about that.
Well, each contestant in the Miss America organization, they have their own personal platform. And for that, it's the passion that you have for a certain topic or subject. And for me, it's volunteering, because ever since I was young, I just got a super huge love for volunteering.
Right.
It's so rewarding to give back to your community with many different things, like just helping somebody cross the street that's an elderly woman, or helping in a retirement home, or cleaning up garbage.
Where do you think that comes from? I mean, like you said, you've identified that you've probably had that inclination from a very young age, and you are young now, but
yes.
What do you think that comes from?
I believe my culture, because I'm Hmong. I'm the first Hmong American state title holder in the Miss America system.
That's fantastic.
Thank you.
That's really neat.
I think part of our culture is a lot about giving back. It's a lot about thinking of others first and always giving a helping hand to others. And that culture aspect, my parents definitely taught me that.
Okay, and it has stuck with me. Mom and dad and culture, and you've taken that. And what a platform to be able to take those characteristics and move forward. Monica, what do you think? What do you think about the platforms and how the organization promotes that and really allows the different contestants to bring their own platform, if you will?
Well, I think it makes our organization unique in that it's not just a beauty pageant.
Right.
Now,
I appreciate that.
Because it is a scholarship organization, it's also based on our community service. And so we make sure that we provide our contestants as well as our title holders opportunities to give back and to do good out in our community. It's amazing to see how the girls react when they go to Blessings Under the Bridge or work with the Christmas, what was that? The Christmas wrapping, the picking, what is that?
Oh, we do Christmas wrapping for Santa Express.
Right, Santa Express,
yes.
that's what it is.
That's a great organization.
And they just love that. They love helping other people. But that's also another huge piece, is making sure that the girls do think of others, that it's not about just you.
Right.
It's about everyone. We want these girls to be productive, you know, human beings in our society.
I think there's a couple components there that are impressive to me, though, is the organization itself is giving the contestants that opportunity, and you're growing from those experiences. You mentioned Santa Express or Blessings Under the Bridge, and Blessings Under the Bridge is a great example of that perspective for the contestants and for the organization. It really does work both ways, and I think the contestants are getting amazing perspective. I've had the opportunity to do that, and I'll tell you, it opened my eyes, too.
Oh, yes.
At the same time, you guys putting forth your volunteer hours is benefiting those organizations. So it's a pretty good symbiotic relationship, I would say.
Right,
yes.
Right, and actually the talent and interview are our biggest percentage as far as, you know, going towards a final score.
Okay, so the algorithm, if you will.
Oh, and absolutely.
And I appreciate you mentioning that, because I think, Monica, an item that you've done a good job of and the organization has is promoting what this scholarship organization really is versus just a beauty contest.
Right. Yes.
I think that type of PR is very important.
Yes, it teaches so much more than
just
to look good on the stage and smile.
Right,
right. Which,
because
historically, sometimes pageants, that word in and of itself gets that reputation, but there's so much more.
Yeah, sometimes pageants unfortunately get a negative connotation, which is unfair because mm-hmm. pageantry really helps develop life skills in young women. Mm-hmm. And I think that's so beautiful to see young women striving for their dreams, getting these scholarships from the Miss yeah. America organization, or they're building their speaking ability by doing these interviews so that when they go into a job interview someday, then they're just prepared to speak about themselves because pageantry has prepared them for
yeah,
that.
Yeah, you walk into that situation and it's kind of old hat to you. Like, mm-hmm. I've done this several times. I've done this on a stage in front of thousands. And speaking mm-hmm. of thousands, the national competition that you're at, how did that look even environment-wise? You were in Orlando, right? How many folks were attending that competition?
It was so much fun. Mm. It was definitely the opportunity of a lifetime. I think a couple hundred or thousand were there, and then it was also live streamed, so it was broadcasted online nationally.
Oh, so millions were watching you do
speak
to your platform.
And I think Spokane was really loud in the audience.
Yes,
I believe
Washington
that.
Was represented well.
I believe that. That's,
it was
that's
fun.
Exciting. Well, you know, all these accolades and all these experiences that you're having, and I think you just indicated this, that the life experience leads you to that first job interview and second job
Definitely
interview.
Yes.
What do you see yourself striving towards as a potential career, or, you know, what do you find that you're passionate about career-wise?
Well, I want to be a legislator someday for foreign policy and international politics.
Okay.
And part of that, I think doing pageants has really moved me to want to do that because I have definitely found that I love speaking and I love educating others on current events and what's going on in our world. I love to engage other people in helping others too. So I just found my passion for legislating.
I think you described that really well too, that you are already speaking for your essentially constituents mm-hmm. in that.
Yes.
You know, you are representing Spokane. You are representing the state of Washington in any location, but when you're down at nationals. And
yes.
really, in and of itself, that's what politicians are supposed to be doing, is representing mm-hmm. our particular area.
Tia, you have an especially unique family situation as well, which I think
I do, yes.
really
tell us about that.
Is kind of in the background there, too, for her decision to go into foreign policy.
Yeah, tell me a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so my parents, they're actually refugees from Laos and Thailand, and with them being immigrants from another country, it has really opened my eyes to all the beautiful opportunities that America allows.
Absolutely.
With their education, my parents were able to get, well, my dad with his doctorate in psychology, and my mom was able to obtain her master's degree.
Okay.
It was just so inspiring for me to see the wonderful beauty that America allows other people.
And the opportunities.
Yes. That's why I'd like to help with that.
Well, and politically speaking, mm-hmm. That's been such a hot topic with immigration,
yes.
et cetera. And it never ceases to amaze me that some of our politicians are forgetting mm-hmm. recently that we are all immigrants one way or the other.
Right.
I mean, that's
exactly.
just
right.
factually the
that's
case.
That's so true.
So
yes.
When we have these restrictions on and that would have meant me or you or
unfortunate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm. so that certainly has been an interesting topic. But I think you at a young age, it's impressive that you're assimilating that information and watching your mom and dad and understanding that the education opportunities
yes.
that has provided here in the U.S. or otherwise, that's impressive on your part.
Thank you.
Such exciting opportunities. I think that this platform of this organization creates that you might not otherwise have experienced had you not seen the booth that you were talking about at the beginning.
I totally agree, yes.
Or been enamored with the tiara, right? Because
yes.
you said you
because
saw that.
Lots exactly. of girls want to be a princess.
I don't know that there's
but
any
But I
don't
think that enough people realize how much dedication and hard work it takes
right.
to really be the title holder.
Right.
And it's a big responsibility, and it is a job for a year, but it's definitely the most rewarding job that I think anybody could have.
Well, and I think as you're indicating, not only is it an amazing time commitment to hold the position, but to attain the position.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I touched on
yes.
this earlier when you were talking about the dance routine or the physical fitness piece.
Mm-hmm.
With both of those, what do you guesstimate your hours a week in terms of training fitness-wise? Or, and I'm kind of combining because the dance obviously is
yes.
very athletic, if you will. What do you think your hours of training for that are?
Well, I dance about 10 hours a week, and then I probably do some type of weightlifting or jogging about 3 to 5 hours a week.
So now we got 15 hours. Mm-hmm. And again, yes. You got to fit in
working
school.
Working on your body. Right. Yeah. Yeah, staying fit, though, is definitely an important component of mm-hmm. being a title holder, because you are being a role model to young mm-hmm. women and yep. showing them that it is very important to live a healthy lifestyle by choosing the right foods and by exercising regularly, because mm-hmm. it's not about being skinny. It's yeah, about being
balanced,
healthy. Yes. And having a balanced lifestyle. Right. Exactly.
How I'm jumping back to your world of politics and being a legislator, which I'm fascinated with, because
yes.
I think that's
Thank
a great
you.
Opportunity for you. How do you see coming out of, you're doing the running start,
yes,
you're going to be a
I
junior at Rogers. What do you think your next step is in terms of four-year college? You're going to be at Eastern for the running start, right? Do you,
yes.
do you think you'll stay there for the full 4 years, if you will, at Eastern?
I'm not sure, actually. I'm still looking into that, but after getting that four-year full ride at the University of Alabama,
right.
Bama sounds pretty great now.
No, you mentioned that, and that type of scholarship's hard to turn down.
Exactly, it is.
Would you foresee that if you ended up at University of Alabama or otherwise, is law school potentially in the future if you're thinking legislature, or is there a different path that you see yourself taking to politics?
Possibly, maybe yeah. law, but I think I still need to take some more classes in college to really figure out
Good for
that.
You. See, you're analyzing, you're thinking, you're critically
yes.
thinking through what works for you.
Yeah, so. I still like to definitely test out. Mm-hmm. I think what's beautiful about being young is that you still have so many opportunities ahead of you, and I'm excited to keep on
well,
doing that journey.
Yeah, good for you.
We're all vicariously Thank living you. Through her.
Right.
Oh, no.
Because, you know, so when I was 16, I mean, I was just doing theater and
right.
that type of thing. I wasn't thinking
awesome.
About really what I
what
wanted
you
want
to do.
To
in the
do.
Future.
I mean, of course, I wanted right. to be a movie star or a famous
yeah.
singer or something,
right.
but
she already
there was
did.
No
you
plan.
You like the tiara, too.
I yes. like the tiara. I do.
Well,
who doesn't?
I know.
You know, but you're talking about the different opportunities and different paths. I think a comment we all end up socializing about is there's so much value in figuring out what you don't want to do.
That's
so,
true.
So, you know, giving different opportunities a chance where you figure out, you know what, I don't want to take this path. However, mm-hmm. I do want to go to the University of mm-hmm. Alabama and I want to be in politics. But you mm-hmm. are putting yourself forward in so many opportunities that some
yes.
other people aren't taking the initiative to do. So.
Mm-hmm.
Extremely impressive
oh,
what
you.
You've accomplished yourself, but also the organization that's providing that opportunity to the young women
that's
here
true.
Locally.
Yeah.
And we are excited. Our pageant is next February.
Okay.
And so we are
Comes
trying
around
to
fast.
Narrow down a date for sure, but hoping that we get a lot more interest.
We're trying to recruit
girls.
We
are a young
yeah.
board. We've only been together for the last year and a half, and so we have a lot of goals, and they're pretty lofty.
But you're attaining those, too.
Absolutely. And having Tia as our state representative
mm-hmm.
coming from Spokane, I think that says a lot about, you know, who we are as a city.
It's
and
fantastic.
And we're drawing these quality young
well,
ladies.
I'm impressed. I appreciate having you both on the show.
Thank you.
Tia, on our way out here, tell us what
yes,
award we
sure.
have here.
Well, at Nationals, at Miss America's Outstanding Teen, I was so honored to come home as the Miss Congeniality Sphere of America Award winner. So
that's fantastic.
That was voted by my fellow contestants, and
I'd say that's
it
as
was
important
so
sweet. As anything.
Yes, yeah. It was so heartwarming to know that my contestants voted for me for that award for being the kindest and most sweet contestant to them.
Well, thank you so much, Tia.
Thank
Monica.
You for having
thank
us.
Thank you for being
thank
here.
You.
Thank you.
Let's Talk Spokane is produced in Spokane, Washington by SpokaneTalksOnline.com, which is solely responsible for its content. Ask us a question, recommend a guest, and hear this program again online anytime at SpokaneTalksOnline.com. Thanks for listening.
Last year alone, Avista customers saved over 53 million kilowatt hours of energy. How? By caulking their windows, programming their thermostats, replacing their incandescent light bulbs with LEDs. Simple things, really. But the energy they saved was enough to power more than 4,000 homes for an entire year. Way to save, everyone. Way to save. Find your way to save at avistautilities.com.
Hi, this is Kurt Stockwell with Well Dressed Walrus. We are a local website design and development company here in Spokane. What we do is build beautiful, usable websites for local businesses. A website needs to be beautiful. It needs to be usable for your users, your customers, and yourself. Contact us anytime. We'd love to talk with you about your online marketing.